cell phone and please stand and join us in the pledge of flag, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much, and again, welcome to the August 19th meeting of the Cumming City Council. Got a copy of the agenda, any corrections? Agenda? So here, motion to be approved as presented.
Second.
Got a second. Discussion, all in favor, show your hand. Unanimous, thank you very much.
Do we need executive session?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Adoption of July City Council minutes. Assume everybody got a copy of the minutes of that meeting. If no correction, the city chair will make a motion. Have a second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay, under acknowledgements, proclamation, and resolution, we have GRPA state swim meet report. Greg, I understand we had a great success out of swim meet. You might bring us up today.
Thank you, Mayor. Yes, we did. As you know, we all came out there and saw the crowds that we had during the swim meet. We hosted the Georgia GRPA Class A State Swim Meet July 25th and 26th at the Aquatic Center. We had 1,200 swimmers from ages 7 to 18 that competed and participated in the event over the 2 days. Our estimates are that we had about 8,000 people that come through the Aquatic Center in that 2 day span. The state swim meet, you bring everyone from grandmother, grandfathers, friends, aunts, uncles, everybody comes and watches. And we also benefited from Forsyth County, we had the largest swim team in the meet. Not only the family come to watch those swimmers swim, but you know, people were taking off work and went there to watch their neighbors swim. So we had a huge crowd. Parking went relatively good. By about 9 o'clock both days, the parking lot at the Aquatic Center itself was filled, but we didn't have the overflow parking that at the National Guard Readiness Center and at Old George College, and we had the two fields up there that. On Saturday mid-morning, we just almost maxed out even over for the park. So the crowds were good, the meet was seamless. Jeremy, Carla, Jason did an outstanding job preparing for the meet and running the meet. From entry fees, heat sheets, concessions, merchandise, the Aquatic Center netted right at $17,000. Which is the most ever netted by a recreation department hosting a state swim meet. Only they don't do quite as good as that. So we're proud of that, the fact that we were able to bring all these people into the community, let them show off our facility to them, and to run a meet. That from the comments we've received, we may have a hard time not getting in the future if we decide to bid on it. We did receive a bunch of congratulations and emails following the meet. Just a couple I really wanted to read to you was from Cartersville Swim Team. The Cartersville would like to thank Cumming and the entire staff for a wonderful experience at the GRPA State Swim Meet this weekend. Our kids, coaches, parents loved the entire experience. Thanks for going overboard with the hospitality, dinner, and the lazy river, and everyone just raved about the pool and the facility. GRPA definitely hit a grand slam out of the park for having Cumming host this event. They're a very small class A swim team. They're focused on making it very special. Thanks again for a wonderful job and for running the class A meet. Hopefully we'll see you next year. That's just a sample of some of the many, many emails and phone calls and congratulations that we received. And, we're proud of that.
Well, certainly you and your staff have all been commended for the job y'all have done. I hear some good, good reports on it. And at the same time, I think you said maybe 8 to 10,000.
We put about 8,000 people through the facility.
And overall, it might have been as much as a $2 million economic impact on this, on the community because of that, with the hotels and motels and all the restaurants and convenience stores and everything. And it was a 2-day event, so I understand it was received very well. Thank you all for a great job.
And we thank you for your support and thank you for allowing us to have the facility where we host this.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, item B, proclamations, American Legion Day proclamation. I have a group of individuals here led by John Arndt and his other members of the American Legion, and spouses, and women who we all appreciate for the work and dedication that this group of individuals do, veterans and retired individuals who work real hard to support the fellow man and fellow veterans. And I have a proclamation that I want to read, and I'd like to ask all of you to come up to receive that. It's American Legion Day proclamation. Whereas the American Legion was chartered by Congress in 1919 on September the 16th as a wartime veterans organization based on four pillars of veterans' affairs and rehabilitation, national security, Americanism, and children and youth. And whereas over the years, the American Legion has become a preeminent community service organization, which now numbers more than 2.5 million members, men and women, in over 14,000 American Legion posts worldwide, working a variety of programs that support the four pillars and benefit our nation's veterans, its service members, their families, the youth of America, and its citizens. And whereas the members of the American Legion are dedicated to upholding the ideals of freedom and democracy while working to make a difference in the lives of fellow Americans. And whereas the 2014 observance of American Legion Day provides an opportunity to recognize Legionnaires in our community for their many contributions to our community. Now, therefore, I exhort Greater Cumming City Council of the City of Cumming, Georgia, do hereby proclaim September the 16th, 2014, as the American Legion Day 2014, in witness whereof, I hereunto set my hand and cause the seal of the City of Cumming, Georgia, to be affixed this 19th day of August in the year of our Lord 2014, signed by 84 Gravitt as mayor and attested to Jeff Honey, city clerk of the city of Cumming. We thank you all very much if y'all would come up.
Service that you give to our veterans and our military and We're delighted to be able to participate and have this recognition from the American Legion. As you say, 2.5 million members, and we're trying to better our community, serve the veterans and their families, promote patriotism and Americanism within our youth. That seems to be our objective. Thank you, sir.
Thanks, and thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you all. Okay, out of 6 of our own meetings, administration, item 1, Bethelview Road Widening. Dan, if you would, you bring us up to date. We had, I think 3 or 4 months ago, or 5 months, it's been 7 months ago that we addressed this issue, but it's come back, so you might bring us up. Council up today.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, members of the council. Y'all will recall several months ago, as the mayor mentioned, the county had requested that we deed them some land and some right-of-way adjacent to our Bethelview Road wastewater treatment plant. The council approved that at exactly the amount that the county appraised the land was worth, which was a very small amount, $2,500 or so, authorized the mayor to execute the deeds. After y'all did exactly what the county asked you to do, the county got back in touch with us and said, we asked you to do the wrong thing. We made a mistake. We don't need the right of way. We don't need the deeds. All we need is an easement. And it's apparently a GDOT oriented project, so they have asked us to give an easement to a small little, almost trapezoid shaped piece of property right where our driveway hits Bethelview Road. For the purpose of them doing construction in that area and then them rebuilding the driveway. I've got them to add a provision that at no time will access to our wastewater treatment plant be closed, because we have to have 24/7 access to that wastewater treatment plant from a safety perspective. It also says that this easement to Georgia Department of Transportation, or GDOT, will expire as soon as the project is completed. So I'm here to ask for a motion first rescinding the offer to sell the city's property, and then secondly approving the easement, which is in your packet. There's a color-coded plat that shows you the trapezoid little portion that they want the easement for, and I respectfully ask that you do those two things by motion.
Question, this is easement is a construction easement, right? And it's,
yes.
And like you said, it's a temporary, it'll be void and null whenever the construction is finished.
It absolutely expires as a matter of law by that on its face. It says it will expire when the project is complete. So just requesting authorization for the mayor to execute that easement and then rescinding your prior action of authorizing the sale of those two little pieces of property that they now have.
Okay, I hear a motion from the board to rescind the action that was taken in a previous meeting to accept the proposal contract that was presented by the Board of Commissioners Engineering Department they decided they didn't need.
I'll make a motion.
I have a motion from Gravitt. I have a second.
Second.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor? Raise your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. And the other one was to agree to the construction easement.
Yes, sir.
I hear a motion that we accept the proposal of a construction easement for that particular piece of property.
I'll make a motion.
I have a motion. I have a second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, item 7 under administration, we have School Street Wide right of way. Dana, I think that's yours too.
Yes, sir. I've got a few in a row here. Members of the council and Mr. Mayor, in conjunction with the construction of the parking deck on School Street that's directly adjacent to the existing county administration building, part of your intergovernmental agreement with the county requires them to widen School Street and make it a two-way street, in addition to building the parking deck there. In order to accomplish that, the county owns a little strip of property, and I think y'all probably have in your packet, or we've shown you in the past, the map of the entire tract. But the county has a strip of property that they will be conveying to the city once it's built into a city street. Right now, it's part of an area they have been parking on, doing surface and parking on. The city has an area down by the playhouse where the county needs a temporary construction easement from us. They have agreed that it won't interfere with our wall or our sign or anything like that. But in essence, the curve is too sharp at that location, and they need to sort of lessen the sharpness of the curve a little bit. So what we're here asking tonight for you is, number one, to accept from the county at such time that the project is complete. The conveyance is, even though it's technically on county property, they'll actually be deeding it to the city because it becomes a city street. So to accept the conveyance of property of the city street when the project is completed, the mayor would be authorized to do that when staff informs him that the project is complete. And secondly, authorizing the mayor to execute such easements and as are necessary for them to complete the project in accordance with the plan, so that School Street, in fact, will be widened its entire length, and the curve at the end of Pilgrim Mill Road will be slightly straightened out so as to ease traffic. I'd be glad to answer any questions that y'all have.
Okay, the motion is to accept the easements that the county wants to donate to the city whenever the project is complete.
Right, and then secondly, to convey to the county a temporary construction easement to complete the parcel that are on, that's currently owned by the city.
Okay, and authorize the mayor to sign the necessary documents to implement that whenever the project is complete. So
I make a motion, whatever he said.
Now, motion approved, a second, John Day.
Yeah.
Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. All in favor, unanimous. Okay. Thank you, Damon.
Yes, sir.
Okay, item two, dumpsters. We've had an issue with dumpsters recently in reference to the some of the department heads, and Danny, you might want to bring us up to date in reference to that.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. We have a number of dumpsters that are on city locations, where we have a need for a dumpster on city property for a particular reason, whether it's at the Aquatic Center or at Dobbs Creek or here at City Hall. We have a couple of them that are under written contract. Most of them are not. The request from staff is that you allow us to terminate the few that are under contract and that we solicit bids for replacement of all dumpsters the city, because what we have found in our investigation is we have different contract rates for basically what appears to be the same dumpster. And what we would like from a staff perspective is to be paying hopefully the same amount and the lowest amount that the city can get on a bid basis. And so we request permission to terminate the existing contracts, and then I think Mr. Bennett and I are going to try and put together a request for proposal or some bid documents to send that out for bid. Well, we'll do whatever the council wants us to do, but I believe that was what our recommendation was. Okay. Steve, you may want to add something to that if I left something out.
The request would be to rescind any contracts that we have with any people with dumpsters on city property.
That's correct.
Okay. And at the same time, we'll advertise for bids for dumpsters to replace these or leave them or whatever.
On all city property.
On all city property.
And hopefully get a better price from the city and a better service.
Yeah, like I said, it's fine. And what I've seen is my understanding that they're all different prices all over the table of dumpsters you have. So
that's right.
Be uniform with all of them.
That's exactly correct, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, what's the pleasure of the board?
Thank you.
Have a motion, have a second. Second. Lewis, in discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you, Bruce. Thank you, Dan.
Yes, sir.
Okay, the Fair Authority?
On the Fair Authority, we have been through these documents before. I believe that they are in your packet or previously been given to you. On this, as y'all know, the Fair Authority has been formed about a year and a half ago. The proposal is that the city would deed the fairgrounds and related fair property to the Fair Authority. The Fair Authority would operate fairgrounds. There would be an assignment of the lease on the Mary Alice Park property, and there's an intergovernmental agreement that has been proposed, that has been approved by the Fair Authority. All these documents have been approved by the Fair Authority. So So if y'all had a chance to review them as a city council and find them to be in order, request an authorization allowing the mayor to execute the documents necessary to enter into the intergovernmental agreement with the fair authority and all required deeds, leases, assignments, and related documents that are specifically talked about in the intergovernmental agreement.
Okay. Council have any questions? Entertain a motion. Entertain any questions. Got a motion, a second, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you, Dan. Okay, I believe the health department ordinance is the last one here.
It's the last one I think that I've been asked to stand up for. I'm glad I got all mine in a row. Mayor and members of the council, the Forsyth County Health Board has asked us to consider adopting the health department regulations that apply in Forsyth County and the city of Cumming, and to allow the city of Cumming to prosecute in municipal court violations of the health code. So the ordinance in front of you basically does that. It adopts as a city ordinance what both state law and county code provide, so that there's no, it'll be seamless as far as the health department is concerned, whether they're inside the city limits or outside the city limits. The difference will be if there's a health code violation within the city limits, that'll be prosecuted in our city court with our municipal judge. And of course, the health department folks that have spoken with me about it, and I think the mayor may have something to add on this, feel like that will help them immensely, because our municipal court operates very rapidly, very efficiently, and they feel like we can basically take care of any violations in a very expeditious fashion. They're very hopeful that the city council will entertain this in a positive way. Mr. Mayor serves on the board as the city's representative. You may want to add something to what I said.
Well, I think what brought this about was the fact that we have issues to come up, and we have Mr. Ed Carter back here with us on the board. I see. What brought this about was anytime there's a citation that might be issued relative to health issues with the health department of coming in Forsyth County, it seems like it becomes a long, drawn-out process before it ever gets satisfied as far as the health base is concerned. And this is a way that's working with the state and the local department, bring it under the city jurisdiction when it's in the city of Cumming to rapidly address the issue. And that's basically the reason that we had they've requested us to do this. Mr. Carter, I don't know where you've got any additional. You want to say anything in addition?
No, I think you covered it. I think it's going to be a time saver, and they'll help the citizens with sometimes different nuisances that bother them. Hopefully we can get them resolved more than a half a year or a year.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Chairman, entertain a motion. Have a motion for adoption of the health ordinance. Have a second. Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you, Mr. Young.
Thank you. Okay. Item B, Park and Recreation. We have a request to advertise for bids for the new park building.
Thank you, Mayor. We are progressing along the coordinating with Paul Handy Architecture. We are progressing with the design of the new recreation building at City Park, or the renovation, to be involved in the renovations at City Park. And those should be finalized in the next couple of 2 to 3 weeks. What we are asking is, rather than waiting until the next council meeting to be able to advertise for bids for the one contract for the construction of this building, if we can receive your grace and your permission tonight to go ahead and advertise for bids for the building once the plans have been for the building have been submitted and have been approved by the staff and the planning and zoning by the department.
What being submitted. What's the deadline on submitting bids?
For the bids for the, you've got my bidding, the plans for the building, or now?
Well, submit the, I mean, I said the bids, what's the timeframe whenever we advertise for contractors to submit?
My understanding is once we advertise, it's 4 weeks from the date that we first advertise and have plans available for pickup, before we can award those bids, or have a bid opening to get.
Do you have plans for the bidders to pick up?
They are not finalized yet. That's what we're asking for is, once those plans are finalized and they have been approved, and we can go ahead at that point and start advertising to receive bids for the construction of the building, rather than wait till the next council meeting in September. Just thinking at this time, we may gain a week or so time to get started working on this a little bit soon.
Well, since we will be having, if you expected the process to come to you before we have our next city council meeting, you say we might say a week or something.
That's correct.
And advertise.
That's what we're hoping for, is that we can get, go ahead and start the advertising rather than wait for after the September. Might say this week, might not say this 2 or 3 days, but if it occurs that way according to the timeline, that's, we'd like to take advantage of being legal we can.
Okay, the request is to advertise for bids upon receiving the plans, and it expects to have the plans in hand before next council meeting. So that's the motion, and that's the request. Chair will entertain a motion to that effect. I have a motion from John D. to have a second. Motion down and back for second. We have a request to item two is a request to grant the contract. Yes, I think we just bypassed the request to advertise for bids for our next meeting now on that part. Item two is the city park grant contract. As council may be aware, at our last meeting, designated me to negotiate the contract on the grading of this park out there, which it was proposed according to the engineer to run around $50,000, and I was unable to negotiate that contract, so we here tonight requested to advertise to be a part of contract for the grading of the city park.
Mayor,
you might have something.
If it'd be all right, this, these are advertised, this is advertised, we schedule to come in on the 27th of this month. And what we'd like to do, if we would do this, if it'd be all right with the mayor and council, is when these do come in, because we are running behind schedule as to what we thought we'd be in that area, we've got an 8.5 acres almost out there. If we would love to get graded and get covered on that before the winter gets to us, and if we could ask that the mayor look at those bids when they come in on the 27th, and you decide as to how we should approach, but if we could get started as quickly as we can, whether you advise Greg or Ben, us, whether we go ahead and call a meeting or whatever we do to get started. We would like to do that to get the grading to move in, and that would also speed up to item one about the building itself. And we've had different things that you're aware of there that slowed us down some on that project. We just want to do what we can to get back on schedule. So if that's possible, that we can come and at least talk to you about it, and you advise us on the 27th as to whether or not we can speed it up, and whether it's a call meeting or whatever it might be.
I think I'm a little confused about the, I think, Greg, you're saying that we won't be allowed to pass bids with council permission, and that'll be 30 days to have to pass the bids.
For the construction.
For the construction project.
Of the building itself.
Yeah.
Once we start advertising, it's 30 days before that it has to be advertised before we can accept the bid or open bids for it. What the item number two is we've been advertising for bids for the grading project for the length of time required. Those bids are due to be open, submitted and open next Wednesday. I think what Gerald's was saying is we would like to see those bids will be open before the next council meeting, and in an effort to move this project along and try and get it back on the schedule.
That's
we're asking your advice on the grading aspect of it, of how to do that.
You're talking about the grading contract will be open next Tuesday?
It will be open next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday. And that's what you're requesting. Review those bids and take the lowest bid if it's in the range that, that we had talked about.
Yes, sir.
Protected by the engineers.
Yes, sir. Whether that's something that they can put you in charge to look at, or whether that would be through a call meeting. We don't want to wait till the next council meeting to approve this, because that's going to be another 2 or 3 weeks behind.
Much pressure for it.
I make a motion that the authorized mayor review the bids, accept the lowest bid.
Got a motion. Have a second.
Second.
We're talking about the grading contract out of
the grading contract.
To review and accept the best bid. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous.
Thank you. Thank you, Mayor.
Okay. Item three is a baseball jersey bid award.
Yes, sir. It's actually our basketball jersey. So we're gearing up for our annual winter basketball league. So we have solicited bids for the printing of 1,200 reversible mesh jerseys with numbers and logos on the front and back. We sent bids out, and we have only received, by the deadline, we only received one bid back in response to that solicitation. The bid we received was from Worldwide Max. It was based out of Oregon, but they had a Cumming distributor, $10.15 per shirt, for a total of $12,180. We have used Worldwide Max in the past, and this is the same per jersey price that they received the bid for last year. So there has not been an increase in their price. They've been efficient in being able to get the work to us in a timely manner, and they have provided an excellent product. So it's our recommendation that we do accept the bid for Worldwide Max.
Out of everyone, all the 5 ones that picked up the bid proposal, we only had this one bid return.
This is our only one return. Yes, sir.
Damn, what's the procedure on when we only have one bid?
You accept that unless it's outside the scope of what the staff recommends from a cost perspective.
So I agree, it was the same price last year.
That's why I think it's acceptable. It? From a legal standpoint, that's obviously your call on whether you decide to accept the legal bid.
Okay, we have a proposal for the jerseys for the park recreation for $12,180. And the company is out of Oregon. It's Max Worldwide LLC, Hillsboro, Oregon. What's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion to repurchase.
Motion and second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you, Greg.
Thank you, Greg.
Okay. Item C, planning and zoning, rezoning application number 2014196, Loretta Biggs, Scott Morgan, Director of Utility, Director of Planning and Zoning.
Yes, sir. Thank you, members of the council. If I could address your attention to the staff report in your packets. This is on behalf of the property owners has made application. lots, totaling approximately 1.53 acres and located at 120 Grandview Drive from moderate family residential, which is R2, to institutional for the purpose of renovating the existing structure and establishing a personal care home. To the best of our knowledge, this proposed rezoning would not be detrimental to surrounding property owners' value, use, or enjoyment of their properties. And the proposed rezoning is in conformance with the city becoming comprehensive and future land use plans. The planning board held a public hearing on July 15, 2014, and with no opposition present, recommended approval of the proposed rezoning with the following conditions. Number one, the existing structure at 120 Raymond Drive will house no more than 7 residents, including staff. Any expansion of this structure and increase the number of residents would require approval by the city council. Condition number two, the adjacent vacant parcel is proposed for development of an additional personal care home will require approval by the city council. And condition number three, the existing structure at 120 Raymond Drive will need to be connected to the city sanitary sewer system prior to the issuance of a certificate of occupancy for the personal care home. And all connection costs will be borne by the personal care home developer or the property owners. I'd be happy to answer any questions and decide if you would need a public hearing.
Okay. And as far as all the applications, and the criteria, you received all the information?
Yes, sir, we have. And so the planning board reviewed it, recommended approval with the three conditions that have for you.
And we need a public hearing?
Yes, sir.
I hear a motion open for public hearing.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Anybody like to speak for the rezoning application? Laura D. Big, rezoning number 2014196. Anybody like to speak in opposition? Hear a motion to close public hearing? Second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay. Scott?
This was asked for the vote at this time whether or not to approve or deny the rezoning request as presented with the commissioners.
I, what's the pleasure of the board? I see we have a letter in the file here from the adjacent property owner, which is Mr. Doug Raymond. All in favor and support of it, and you have no opposition, my understanding. So we have a recommendation from the planning and zoning board that it be approved. So, chair, entertain a motion. We have a motion, John D. Have a second. Right. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thanks, Scott. Okay, item two, alcohol license request for the sale of malt beverages, wine and steel spirits by package, Cumming Liquors, Mr. Copeland.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, Council. Yes, planning zoning received a application for package retail sale of wine, beer, and steel spirits from Cumming Liquors, which is located in the property from the Costco. We've completed a background check on the premises and also the manager of the store. All the fees have been paid, and my recommendation is that the city grant the license.
Council, have any questions? Chair, entertain a motion. Have a motion, have a second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, John. Also, item three, under planning zone, we have alcohol license request for sale of Gravitt's filling station.
Yes, sir. It claims on receiving an application from the for the issuance of a gravel license for the company in the filling station on Marketplace Boulevard. The owner of the business has worked hard to get that premises up to in compliance with the Department of Revenue regulations as well as the city coming alcohol ordinance. Completely satisfied that all that work has been done, and our recommendation is to issue a license. All the fees have been paid, and the background checks have been approved as well.
And that building is Marketplace. That's Erickson beverage plant, right?
Yes, sir, that's correct. Being that it is connected to the building, some of the things that we're required to do was get a separate address for that. Since they are licensed to Jack's license, so it's still spirits that could be connected. They have some extra construction to actually, for the segregated, the building to get a separate address for them.
All right, looks like they've made all the qualifications. What's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion.
Have a motion, have a second. Second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor and Council.
Okay, D, Police Department, Chief Tatum, certification for public convenience for vehicle by our request.
We have a number of answers. We've seen application from Andrew Reed, last week, I'll see you. I should do the business, the cab. The question of public hearing, the unit was particularly the public convenience being hired. This is located in 407 West House Square in Street 31. We did a background check, they claim, on this party in their business. There are nothing disclosed to approve issues of certificate. And our application, everything is in compliance with the security of the high. So it does require a public hearing if we need it.
Okay, I hear most vote for public hearing.
Make a motion.
Have a second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Okay, we have anyone here who'd like to speak in favor of certification of public convenience vehicle for our request, which is a taxi service. Have anybody like to speak in opposition? Have a motion to close public hearing. Have a second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay.
It will require a vote to approve or deny.
And is your recommendation for approval?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have a motion approved.
Approved, sir.
Second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay, under item E, Department of Utilities, request to advertise for bids for setting down clean pump station in Horse Bank. John, Director of Utilities.
Mr. Mayor, members of the City Council, as you're aware, there's quite a bit of growth in Scott County. And one of the last areas for development in the city of Warner Sewer Service Area is north of Sunny Mountain and Spot Road. City of Warner Sewer Service Area is boundary to the north is Highway 369, to the west is Doc Brandon Road. And in this certain area that we're talking about tonight, Spot Road is the southern boundary. And that entire area drains naturally by gravity. It's what you call a drainage basin. So anytime it rains in any of that area, it all flows in at one point. They're setting down three crosses on Doc Brandon Road. So in order to capture all the wastewater generated by development in that basin, the city needs to install a wastewater pumping station along setting down three at Doc Brandon Road. And we have a preliminary design, we have some preliminary easements that we're working on right now. And the Department of Utilities is requesting that the Mayor and Council allow us to advertise for bids for this pump station in Horse Bank, which is phase one of the project. It'll be several phases as time goes on to sewer that entire drainage basin. But as phase one of the pump station in Horse Bank, we're requesting that you allow us to advertise for bids and bring bids back to you by the October council meeting.
I think you had said this drainage basin consisted of over 7,000 acres of land in there, I believe it was.
That's correct.
And maybe your hope was that once you got the master line in, that this development, that property, a lot of that development, the infrastructure would be built by the developers.
That's correct. That's the hope. And there's quite a bit of demand, potential demand up there, a lot of undeveloped property. I've had several property owners approach me about school passing, and so for us to take this initial step, I believe will open the doors for more development and more property to be tied up in the school system, which will help pay for the infrastructure.
All right, we have a request from the Department of Utilities for the
service for the outbound area, the city service area. Chair, entertain a motion. Have a motion, have a second. All in favor, say if I can read your name. Any opposed? Unanimous, thank you, gentlemen. Okay, item two, request a award bid to decommission marketplace pump station.
Mr. Mayor, members of the city council, we've been working to acquire these bids. Back here, I sent an updated list to you, I placed it for you, each one of you. These bids were received, there were three bids, and these are updated, my three package, I updated this morning. Strack Incorporated bid $94,888. Jasper Grading $125,365. And Green Grading $143,250.69. And Department Utilities is requesting that Mayor Council accept the lowest bid from Strack at $94,888.
And looking at their bid sheet, and this is something we had talked about after the bids were submitted. I was looking at the pump station. If that pump station is left in place and not taken out, they have $15,359 for that price, that alone, that bid sheet. Is that something that before anything's approved, that you can talk to them about and see if they're willing to give up that part off? If we can leave that pump station in place, even though it won't be in service, but at some point in time, that pump station could be valuable at another location.
That's great. That's what we hope to do, is to preserve that pump station as is. If you look at this prior new bid sheet, the decommission line out of zero. So Jasper Grading, they've not got a line out of work, so it was zero. And I instructed these two contractors to take that out. Strack has an amount in there, what that's for is just pull the pumps out and the pipe, put the pipe through the well, and you fill that in with gravel. So, in essence, that's the easiest way to take this thing online, is line them from Walmart. So, when you get current, the place in the well, there's a line from the street from all the restaurants, they currently fill the well. So, what this would mean would be pull the pumps out and put the pipe in, and drill the two pipes so the sewage can flow through the well. If we're not including removing the need for equipment there, except the pumps just keep them out of the well, build that in and turn it into a manual. So previously they had $5,000 in there, or $4,000 in there to decommission the rest of it, pull the generator out and all the control panels. And I instructed them not to take anything out and set up a little bit of it to $94,888.
Would that pump station work with the Ramsey Road?
No, sir. That area is, one, is quite a bit larger. And also, when you look at these pumps, the elevation has a lot to do with it. We have quite a bit of elevation. That area actually drains to the Elmore River, where everything on this side of Summer Mountain drains to the Chattahoochee River. So we've got a whole basin over time with elevation. So that pump station is too small for that. We're looking to see if maybe the Baptist Hospital construction, the one that we've been working on that's now completed, see if those pumps can work. They're 88 horsepower, and they pump quite a distance ahead. And it's possible that those can work. So we're preserving all those pieces and parts as a potential option for that. At least as a first phase, and this time it was only replaced.
Okay, you said they had an alternative. They didn't fill in the manhole that they deduct
That's correct. We had a bid of $98,888, and the alternate bid is $94,888, so not just landing compensation. So we have had to be left down to $4,000.
Which way, of course, the bids is for dismantling the crop station, but you think it's worthwhile to go ahead and dismantle it, put that in storage, that equipment, all in storage?
Yes, that's what we plan to do, on our own, as cheap as possible, to pick up all that equipment and put it in, have a pole barn, you know, keep all that infrastructure together, so we can just pick that thing up and, you know, install it. You know, in case there's an interim step, you know, with that basin, it's a large drain basin, it might make a lot of sense to install a pump station, say, midway, you know, to save time. I think we would use that.
What's the pleasure of the board? Have a request from Strack Incorporated, who probably is the reason their bid is so cheap, they're already on site. I understand, they're working on that development, well, there.
Yes, sir, in addition to the all the cost of the stuff.
They've done a lot of work in the area, so they're about $25,000 to $30,000 cheaper than the next bid. So, what's the pleasure of the board? Have a motion from John D. to accept the bid as presented. Is that correct, gentlemen? All right. Have a second. Second from Ralph. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Okay. We have a request to advertise for bids for water line for Dr. Brown and Crowley.
Similarly, the basin's growing. Not only do we have an sewer infrastructure, we also have needs the water line along Bobbrink Road. We'll be installing this first phase of an outer loop that will go from Wallace Lake Road on Bobbrink Road all the way up to 369 and along 369 Henders Road. But the first phase of this project would be, and this is what we're requesting that you allow us to advertise for this for, would be the Wallace Lake Road along Bobbrink Road up to the northern leg of Byers Road. So we would like to request that the mayor and council allow us to advertise for bids for this 12-inch water line on the bottom of the road.
Okay. What's the pleasure of the board? Request to advertise for water lines on Dr. Brown and Crowley.
Make a motion.
Have a motion. Have a second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, John, you have a sit down creek drainage basin sewer, special sewer charge district.
Mr. Mayor, members of the City Council, to pull your map out, I'm sure you're looking at it now. The Department of Utilities has delineated the drainage basin over the city down creek area, and it's our request that we increase our sewer capacity charges from $20 per gallon per day and 5,000 gallons per day. 5,000 gallons per day is for each residential unit. $20 per gallon is for any type of commercial development. We want to go from 5,020 to 6,250 per home, or $25 per gallon per day for commercial development. We have another special sewer district along around Hawthorne Road and Highway 20 and Beaver Dam Road. It's priced similarly. $6,250 for each residential unit, $25 per gallon per day for each commercial development. So we're requesting that you allow us to raise the sewer capacity reservation fees in that drainage basin and to $6,250 per residential unit and $25 per gallon per day for commercial development.
Otherwise, an normal price would be $20.
Yes, sir.
5,000 per tap.
That's right.
Okay, and we currently have districts in place for this same fee as we've done the same time.
That's correct.
What's the pleasure of the board? Motion group. Have a second?
Second.
Right. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Mayor, you can see. Thank you, John. Okay. We have announcements. Dave, he's not here, but he's got a having the rodeo August 29th. And 30, two nights of rodeo coming up. That's always a great event down at the fairground. We have a department head meeting September the 11th. We'll have a fire authority meeting November the 13th at the fairground. Also, Costco opening, big store, box store on Barbary Road will be open August 29th at 8 o'clock. We'll make that announcement. And Playhouse, we have play that's going to be going on starting September 4th through September 28th, Mama Won't Fly. So that's a great play that's going on, I understand. And we'd like to certainly be invited to that. And any other business come for this board? I hear motion to adjourn. Second, all in favor, signify by raising your hand. We have a schedule of 7 o'clock. We'll do, take a 5-minute break and we'll be ready for that meeting.
Have a good one. We'll see you. How are you doing?